All right, and we're back. Okay, so what's up, everyone? Welcome back to my corner, or welcome to my corner if this is your first time here. If you know me at all, you know that I am terrible at posting on time. Absolutely terrible. I know it's been a while. Life's been weird. But to get more to the point today, well, actually, stay tuned, because, like, I've got stuff for y'all at the end of the video that I want to run past you. Anyways, today I want to work on turns, because, like, turns are important. If you're in lower levels of gymnastics, it doesn't really matter that much, but they're great to start learning now, because they're tricky to get the hold of sometimes. But anyways, in case you don't know, later on in gymnastics, dance and gymnastics meet in the middle. If you've ever seen high level, like college level gymnastics, or the Olympics, which are coming up, and you should totally watch it, it'll probably be on a sports channel or something. Yeah, dance and gymnastics come together. At least for the, on the women's side. But, anyways, turns can be difficult. You're falling over, you're stepping out of them, or you're wanting to work on your upgrade turns, full and a half turns, wolf turns, all the good turns. So today, I want to go over the basics of a turn and how they work. So, let's just dive right in. Figuratively, of course. So, naturally, you're going to want to start in your passe shape. Now, the trick about this, or not passe, this is passe, your start position, all right? I call this start. I know there's a technical term for it somewhere in like dance or something, but the trick is you don't want to be winding up. What does that mean? Good question. All right, so wind up means you're reaching back to throw your arm forward. You don't want any of that because that's going to continue all sideways. You're going to go weird. It's going to be weird. You're going to fall and land on your face, and it's not going to be good. All right? So you want to make sure everything is square. What does square mean? That means everything's in line. Your hips are forward. Your shoulders are forward. You're not all this weird sideways. You want your chin up because you're looking down. You're also going to turn weird, but you don't want to be looking up the ceiling either. So chin up, level, arm out. You want to be holding like half a beach ball. So hug your beach ball, and this arm is going to close. That's what spins you, okay? Remember, you don't want to reach behind you. You want to keep it level with your shoulder and close. All right? See how my shoulder's already, my body's already turning? That's what's going to turn you. All right? Now let's talk about the next step, which is your passe. All right? Passe. What is a passe? Another good question. That's where your foot meets your knee. This is passe. You want to be in releve. That means tiptoe. Passe, releve. So, let's start. And then from here, you're going to close and up. Step down. Ready? One, two, three, close, up, down, finish. All right? Now, something important. Always step in front. Always step in front. All right? You don't want this foot to be landing somewhere behind you or to the side of you or anything like that. You always want it going forward, because if you do it in competition, you step to the side, you do this gorgeous turn, you step to the side, and it doesn't even count for anything. You always got to step in front and finish it. Get into the habit of finishing. Make it look pretty. You can finish up. You can finish down with a little bit of pizzazz, all right? I don't know why I said pizzazz, but it did. So, you want to show it off. If you practice it now, showing it off, it's going to be so much easier later when you want to compete it next season. All right? So, ready? Let's do it with me. So, start, chin up, arm out, not backwards, facing right in front of you. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, down, finish. Beautiful. Let's do it again. Ready? And one, two, three, up. One, two, down, finish. There we go. I only counted two because I lost my balance. But that's okay. I hope y'all can hear me good over there. If not, I don't know, captions maybe? Oh yeah, by the way, if you hear weird noises, I've got music on Spotify, my little Google Dot thingy. I don't own any of the music. It's just on Spotify for anyone. But I like music, so here we are. Alrighty, so now we're gonna talk about the actual turn. Well, we're not really gonna talk about it, we're gonna do it. First off, make sure you've got plenty of space. I know it looks like I'm really close to the fish tank, but I'm not. Speaking of which, fish tanks. I have fish tanks. I post about those sometimes on Wednesdays. Check it out. Anyways, back to turns. You want to have a wide space just in case you do fall. You don't want to whack something. Alright? Get room. You can go outside, living room, whatever. As long as you got space. Alrighty? So, we're going to do the turn for realsies now. We're gonna do half turns. We always start with half turns. Even if you're working full and a half turns or something, always start with half. That way you get your balance, you get the feel for it, and it's just good to work on. Alrighty? Just trust me on that one. It's good for you to do. So, we're gonna do the count. 1, 2, 3, pull up, turn. Alrighty? Now you wanna stay on your toes. Oh yeah, that's another trick. So your foot. You want to stay on this part of your foot. If you're flat foot, your pinky toe's going to catch and your whole foot's going to turn sideways and you're going to eat it. All right? So, you want to keep your toes up a little bit. That way they don't catch on the carpet. And you want to turn right here. All right? The moment you drop your heel on the floor is going to get so much harder. Okay? Great. Let's do it. So, start. Chin up, arms up. 1, 2, 3, up, turn, step down, finish. And again, arm out. Oh yeah, make sure you're pointing your foot. That just makes it prettier. So point, up, and go. Full turn that time. So wasn't paying attention. So yeah, fish, got a text, ready, and again. So you're here. You want to pull straight up the ceiling. That's what's going to keep your balance. If your arms aren't straight, one of them's sagging over, you're going to end up falling that way or falling the other way. And if you don't pull straight, you're going to end up twisting sideways. All right? You don't want to twist sideways. So you want to pull straight up like you've got a string attached to your head or something and it's pulling you straight for the ceiling. All right? You don't want your string pulling you sideways because that's not going to end well. So, ready? Let's do it again. Try a full turn. If you're working full turns, give it a try. All right, ready? So, arm out, chin up, foot ready. 1, 2, 3, up, close, step down, finish. There we go, all right. I'm sure yours was wonderful. Now remember, if your toes are catching on the carpet, lift them up a little bit. You're leaning sideways, you're either not pulling straight or you're dropping an arm in the middle of your turn. Something else to be aware of is your knee position. You want it right in front of you, not sticking out the side. That's gonna knock you over a little bit too. With practice, it can be done, but it's just a little bit trickier. All right? I feel like spotting is another important thing. Not like your coach spotting you or anything, but spotting, bend with your head. You want to focus on something, watch it for as long as you can, especially when you're doing full turns. Half turns, it's not as important, okay? Full turns, full and a half turns, doubles. You definitely need to be spotting, all right? Otherwise, you're going to get dizzy, you're going to get lost, and you're going to fall over and utter failure. Now, if you're having some trouble actually turning on the carpet, something that helps you a lot, or if you don't realize you're leaning, something to tell you you're leaning real quick, is to get one of those front edger sliders, you know? And do turns on that. I wouldn't suggest doing them on your toe right away, but if you can do it perfecto on your flat foot, just gliding around that frontager mover slider thing, go up on your toes. That definitely fixed mine while I was still competing. Though, be prepared to have that thing go sliding out from underneath you and you fall like a tree in the forest. Come bam! Alright? Because it happens. It really does. That is one of the best ways to teach you if you are leaning or not. Because if you are, you're going down really fast and it's not going to feel good. You're going to get like carpet burn on your elbow and all that good stuff. So make sure you have like a crash zone if you're trying it on your slider, and go slow, okay? It'll also let you know if you're winding up. Remember what we were talking about earlier, the wind up thing? It'll let you know that real fast too, because you're going to spin out of control real easy, all right? Trying to think. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this video. Turns, practice, grab those sliders, repeat it over and over again. Remember the 1, 2, 3, up, go, step down, finish. Do that on your own. Count it for yourself. Have a friend count it with you or for you. It really, really helps. All right? Great. So I will see y'all. Oh, wait. No, never mind. I nearly forgot. So what I was talking about early, the very beginning of the video, where I wanted to run some stuff past y'all, is so I'm thinking about changing the name of my channel from Krista's Corner to My Corner, because I always say, welcome back to My Corner, and all that. And it just rings better, you know? So I'm probably going to end up changing the name of my channel to My Corner. Also, something else, just out of curiosity's sake, give me some feedback. I want to know what y'all think. Is, you know how, like, the big YouTuber Mr. Beast has, like, different, like, sub-channels, like gaming and his normal stuff and whatever? So I'm thinking about doing something similar, because there's a bunch of stuff that I love and would love to talk about, like books, or movies, and roleplay, and, my weird diet stuff, because I have allergies, and would like to share tips with y'all, because it's a lot. So, let me know what you think, like, My Corner Gymnastics, My Corner Fish. My Corner. I know that would be like lots of more work on myself here. And I know I'm not good at posting consistently with the two types that I'm currently running, but I'm hoping that it would like help me to post more, you know, or at least something. But yeah, tell me what you think. And do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button if you found this helpful. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe, hit the bell notification so you can know when I post, because I don't post often, so you'll want to know when I do. Let me know if there's anything you want to see tutorial-wise or other video-wise in general, like food. What do I eat? I can't have gluten, oats, a little bit lactose intolerant, no tomatoes, potatoes, peppers, or eggplant. So if you're curious how I eat, let me know. And tutorial-wise, I was a competitive gymnast for, 8 years. I competed as Excel Platinum or AGA Junior 10 or... that rounds out to be junior, and JO rounds out to be about, a 6, level 6, training 7. So, I've got info, I've got stories, let me know what you want to see from me or hear from me, stick it down in the comment section, and I will get back to you. But till then, stick with it, or something.